The green is the historical range of grizzly bears. And when westward expansion happened, when a lot of folks started moving east to west, grizzly bear were not desirable to be around because they posed a threat to human safety. So they are very systematically eradicated from all of these historical areas. You are here in this stand of grizzly bear habitat, and it is only this way because grizzly bear have been reintroduced into this area.
Okay.
And preserved. It's a national park. The largest grizzly bear actually used to be in the Central Valley of California. They were eating acorns from oak trees, grasses. They were massive. So that's why there's a grizzly bear on the California state flag. But grizzly bears don't exist there anymore.
We saw bears, not once, but twice. We were back on the road driving towards Yellowstone. Yellowstone National Park is the first national park in the US and also widely known to be the first national park in the world. This is a beautiful drive. This reminds you why US is famous for road trips. We were planning to go around Yellowstone in a loop, entering the park via south entrance towards Madison, where we are staying for the night, then driving north and east in the morning, checking out all the features on our way and out via the west entrance on Montana border. On the way, we decided to stop at the Jackson Lake Lodge to check out its famous lobby. It was grand, and so was the view of Grand Tetons from there. And on the way, for the first time on this trip, we saw a bear. Due to heavy traffic, we were not able to stop, but we could see that it was a grizzly bear and its butt was towards us. It looked more like a distant brown blob. Our first stop after entering the park was to visit the West Thumb Geyser Basin. Geysers are hot springs in which water boils and sometimes sending a tall column of water and steam into the air. The whole place was smelling like sulfur due to the chemical reaction happening in the hot springs. There are boardwalks made to walk along the springs to protect the fragile terrain around it. Then we visited the main attraction of the park, that's Old Faithful. It seems the Old Faithful always erupts after every certain hours. I believe it's because of this predictable pattern it's called as the Old Faithful. We had around an hour to kill before the next eruption, so we visited the Old Faithful Inn, which was huge and a grandiose structure. The whole structure was made of wood. Then it was about time. When it happened, we were amazed. After that, we were on our way towards the next basin. Then we saw our first bison. The wind, the steam, and the color of the geysers created this beautiful, magical landscape which was out of this world. Next day morning, we visited the Roaring Mountains. We then stopped to see our second grizzly, who was having his breakfast. How to know it's a grizzly bear? A grizzly has a small hump on its neck, similar to what a camel has on its back, but much smaller. Black bears don't have one. Color doesn't matter. Both can be brown, black, or of mixed sets. Next on our list was the Mammoth Hot Spring Terrace. When we saw the Mammoth Hot Spring Terrace from across the road, it was evident that few of the springs have dried out. This was a dramatic landscape. On our way to the tower fall, there is a section of road where we stopped to check out the rock formation. These were columnar basalt formation. These rock formations are formed due to cooling of thick flow of lava. We then visited the tower waterfall later. On the way towards Yellowstone Falls, we saw a bear swimming along the river next to the road. We stopped and went towards the water to check it out. There was a moment when the bear saw us and started swimming towards us. There are many others watching along with us, but suddenly it changed its direction and again swam along the river. And then we visited Upper and the Lower Yellowstone Falls, two of the major falls on the Yellowstone River, which creates Grand Canyon of the Yellowstone. This was our last stop for this trip. On our way towards the park exit, we also saw many scattered herds of bison. And then it was finally time to say goodbye to Yellowstone.